Welcome to the world of Hollywood, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window in favor of guts, glamour, and glory. Where from car chases to gun battles to whatever the heck this is, nothing seems to make sense. But hey, it seems possible enough, right?
I know what you're thinking, punk. You're thinking, did he fire 6 shots or only 5? Now, to tell you the truth, I forgot myself and all this excitement.
Hollywood's greatest sin seems to arise when it comes to guns, specifically the effects of bullets, or lack thereof.
You could ask yourself a question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Wait. What just happened? Now granted, it is the most powerful handgun in the world. But really, one bullet? Let's take a closer look. Now we can calculate what the final velocity of the bullet and Mr. Bad Guy should be if we use the law of conservation of momentum. Now, using highly idealized values for mass and velocity, we determine the final velocity to be about 0.2 miles per hour, nowhere near what the movie depicts. Now, we got together our special stunt crew in order to recreate the events.
Now, this is how it goes in the movie. Now this is how it should have gone. Psych, I'm not dead, bitch!
Now let's take it to the world of heroes. Now there's a few things wrong with this picture, besides of course the fact that he managed to catch a bullet. But the movie depicts that the bullet is seemingly unscathed, and his skin is unpierced by the bullet. Now let's take a closer look at the math. Now in order to calculate the force of the bullet, we first need to determine its acceleration, using a standard kinematic equation. Applying this force to the estimated area based on the diameter of the bullet gives us over 4 billion pascals of pressure, way over the necessary threshold required to pierce the skin barrier. Here's our stunt crew's take on the events that transpired.
You asshole!
Here's how it should have gone down.
Oh! Oh my god, you shot my head! What the hell?
Gimmicks. We have guns.
Now, what do you have of bullets? And the hope that when your guns are empty, I'm no longer standing. Because if I am, you'll all be dead before you've reloaded.
That's impossible!
Kill him.
Now hold on there, Superman. You just did what? Forget throwing knives. This guy shouldn't even be standing. Just how many bullets can a man take? Now, using rough estimates for mass and velocity, we can calculate the kinetic energy of every bullet fired by every gun in the scene. There were 2 SMGs, 10 handguns, and 1 revolver, each firing until their magazine was empty. Even if V was wearing some kind of bulletproof vesting, all that energy has to go somewhere. In the end, we find he absorbed somewhere in the neighborhood of 142,000 joules of energy. That's around, transferring that into force, we get about the weight of 2 elephants. So, how'd he do it?
You see, back in the day, I had a bulletproof vest, I'll admit it. But you know, the pain really kicked in afterwards. As you can see, the years, they haven't been kind to me. I need to take my energy drinks every few minutes. Speak of the devil, toss me one, eh? There we go.
Now, to be fair, not every movie violates the laws of physics. But certainly some really do border on the insane. Yeah. Love him or hate him, bad physics in movies are here to stay. So next time you're in the theater, get off your high horse and just enjoy the film.
So, what are we really made of?
Dig deep inside the atom and you'll find tiny particles held together by invisible forces. Everything is made up of tiny packets of energy born in cosmic furnaces.
The atoms that we're made of have negatively charged electrons whirling around a big bulky nucleus. The quantum theory offers a very different explanation of our world.
The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. The universe is made of 12 particles of matter, 4 forces of nature. That's a wonderful and significant story.
Suppose that little things behaved very differently than anything big. Nothing's really as it seems. It's so wonderfully different than anything big.
The world is a dynamic mess of jingling things. It's hard to believe.
The quantum theory
is so strange and bizarre. Even Einstein couldn't get his head around.